What's going on, guys? Welcome back to this episode of Custom of the Vic. For today's project, we got these Travis Scott Air Force Ones. I've been having such a hard time coming up with this concept until I saw Zuki's custom TikTok video showing us this new interesting technique. I've never done this new technique, so we're gonna find out if it actually works. So without further ado, let's get it started. The first thing we're gonna do to get started with this custom is to clean up these shoes. The best way to clean up the canvas on these Travis Scotts is by using our Rejuvenator Signature Shoe Cleaning Kit that comes with all three brushes, shoe trees, solution, laundry bag, and towel. We'll also be using our cleaning mat, pods, and our bowl to execute a good cleaning. The first thing we're gonna do is remove our laces and insert our shoe trees. Shoe trees are in place. We're also gonna remove the swooshes. We don't need these right now. All right, now we're gonna grab our solution and squirt two squirts inside our bowl of water. All prepped, ready to go. Let's get started with this cleaning. The first brush we're gonna be using is our stop bristle to start breaking down all the grime on the canvas. Looks great so far. From what I'm seeing, a lot of the stains came out nicely using our stop bristle brush. So I think for this cleaning, we're just gonna skip the medium bristle brush and go straight to the stiff bristle brush to clean up these soles before we put them inside the washing machine. Pre-cleaning is complete. Now let's put the shoe inside the single laundry bag. Before we do that, we still got our laces and our patches. These really aren't that dirty, so we're just gonna put them inside the laundry bag and let the washing machine do its thing. To the washing machine. We're back. We got the shoe fully dried and clean. We got a fresh base to work with. Thanks to our signature shoe cleaning kit that you'll find at rejuvenator.com. Now the first thing we gotta do is some prep work. We're gonna tape off the entire outsole and use a seam ripper to remove the tongue tags before we start dyeing the shoe. We're all prepped, now it's time to test out this new technique. We're gonna need some shaving cream, a bin, and some red dye. For this, we went with the green. I think it's gonna look cool on this custom. Again, I'm not exactly sure how it's gonna turn out, but in my head, I'm thinking it's gonna get this cool, inconsistent tie-dye look. Let's test it out. Check this out, you guys. We got these fully rinsed, dried, and fully dyed. They came out so dope. The process itself was real easy, real simple. I will definitely do it again. One thing I did learn from this process though, once the dye is on the shoe, the next time I'm gonna let it sit for a lot longer before I rinse it so a lot of that color can stay inside the canvas. Right now, it has that faded, inconsistent look, which is what I was going for, but the next time, if I want a darker color, just leave the dye longer on the shoe. The next thing we're gonna do is put our tags back onto the tongues. I removed them because I didn't want this piece to get dyed. Now we're gonna put them back on. We're gonna use some double-sided tape and then sew them on my sewing machine. Stacks are back on the tongues. I'm really glad I took those off before I dyed the rest of the shoes because I like the contrast that it creates. Now we're on to some stencils. For this, we're gonna lay down some Cactus Jack logos on both sides of the shoe. It's gonna be in the same green as the uppers, so it can be subtle and not too loud. But first, we gotta create the stencils. Stencils laid down, like I mentioned before, the color we're gonna be using is a green. It's gonna be very close to the green on the uppers. I want it to be subtle, not too loud. Let's lay it down while using the airbrush. Stencils are laid down, that came out clean. Now we're on to the hard part. We gotta lace these shoes up. The thing is, I don't know exactly what color to use. I walked around the entire Rejuvenator building, asked for everybody's thoughts and opinions. These are the colors we all came up with. We got brown, fadeaway purple, fadeaway pink, neutral white, cream, buttermilk, pistachio, and fadeaway royal. I think all of these will look really good with the peacock green. I don't know what it is, but the fadeaway purple is really calling my name on these. I think it'll look really good with the peacock green. My second option was the fadeaway pink, just because Travis Scott uses pink a lot on his shoes, but ultimately, this is the option. All right guys, that is gonna bring us to an end on these custom Travis Scott Air Force Ones. This was a fun project because I learned something new. With the shaving cream dye technique, you can pretty much apply that to anything that's leather, canvas, such as Chucks, Vans, Air Force Ones, you name it. And it's really cheap also. Between the dye and the shaving cream, it only cost me $15. After I dyed the whole shoe with the peacock green, I moved on to laying down a stencil on the back heel using the Travis Scott logo just to give it a little bit more pop. I removed the Nike Air tongue tags just so I could stay clean and match the midsoles. Then I laced them up with some Fox Shell laces and put all the accessories back to complete the look. I hope J Collector likes these because this is what he's getting. This is Vic Almighty. I'll catch you guys next Monday. See you guys.